At no point in your rambling, incoherent response were you even close to anything that could be considered a rational thought. Everyone in this room is now dumber for having listened to it. And may God have mercy on your soul.
John McClane had a guy on the plane, but it was okay back in the day. It's 88. He was on his way to celebrate Christmas with his hoe. The guy who sat beside him said,
make fists with your toe.
He stepped aside the limo, rolling with a straight G. Argyle, the driver, bumping Run DMC. He's heading to the party down at Nakatomi Plaza. Got a big stuffed bear for his daughter, he's a father. Arrived shortly after, has a Barney with his bitch. Takes the shoes off his feet so that he can make fists. He's trying to relax, hears the sound of a gap. Terrorists are taking over, so he sneaks out the back. But he's the kind of guy to fight and get the job done. Starts taking out the terrorists one by one. Kills the main guy's brother, sits him down on his bum. Writes, ho, 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 now I've got a machine gun. It's not long before Hans is on the case. Kills Mr. Nakatomi with a blast to the face. Gets Ellis on the blower, hoping John will die. He says, Hans, Bobby, I'm your white knight. But don't take John McClane for no sucker. Yippee-ki-yay, die hard, motherfucker. He's got a gang seller, take to his back. Blast Hans out the window, roll credits, that's that. Back at them comfy seats, if you wanna watch a film with me, take a trip down memory lane and see what I have seen. We got a couple of favorite flicks, we're gonna lay them down on this bay. So pick your ears and listen to this and hear what your eyes can't see.
First off, the narrator's got a gun in his face with enough explosive freaks that we can blow up the place. But let's go back to the beginning so we're all in the loop. The story starts and it's to get the cats and support crew. Now I guess you know what's next. Our narrator's face is squished in Meatloaf's sweaty breast. He meets a girl named Marla and hates the Gus. He meets a guy named Tyler on a plane and hits it off. Meets Tyler in the bar and then his fisty cuffs. And may they loved it so much and they started a little club. He quits his big job but still needs a loot. So in between the fights you know he's probably peeing in your suit. Switch to making soap, Tyler starts taking over. Fucking Marla, Project Mayhem, yeah, the path to disaster. But wait, mate, I'm running amok. I forgot the first rule, you don't talk about Fight Club.
Back at them comfy seats, if you wanna watch a film with me, take a trip down memory lane and see what I have seen. We got a couple of favorite flicks, we're gonna lay them down on this.